Hello, my name is Kelly Bluen. I am a certified Zentangle teacher. Welcome to 15 Minutes of Zen. In these videos, I show you how to make one tangle pattern using the Zentangle method of drawing. Today, I'm using my Micron pen. This is a PN, plastic nib pen. I have a graphite pencil for drawing and shading and a blending tool called a tortillon. I'm also using 2-inch by 2-inch tiles from Zentangle.com, and these are called the Bijou tiles. So today's tangle is Sendeo by Stephanie Jennifer, and it is number 22 in a challenge called Inktober. So during the month of October, the artist who created this particular tangle happens to be the same person who puts together a list every year of 31 tangles for us to try. So I'm excited to try one of her tangles today. At the end of this video, I will be adding this one to a compilation piece that has the first 21 tangles already on it, and we will add this one to it. So follow along for Sendeo and stick around afterwards to see the compilation piece come together, and I hope that you are having a wonderful Inktober. Okay, let's get started. For Sendeo, I'm going to begin by putting a dot in each of the four corners and then connecting those dots to create a little frame. Okay. All right, so this one is similar to Kahlua that we did a few days ago in the sense that it's kind of this little U-shaped pattern, and often we find it around an orb and we see 1, 2, 3, 4. So of course I wanted to do something a little bit different to change it up. So we're gonna put ours in the four corners going out towards each other, and we'll see how that works. Okay, I'm gonna take my pencil and I'm just gonna give myself a little guideline here. Of course, you don't have to do this part. It just helps me organize where I want this tangle to land. Okay, so to do Sendeo, we begin with a U shape and an orb, and it is up to you which one you'd rather do first, but I think I'm gonna do my U shape. So I'm gonna make a U that goes like this. It's about the width of my pen and about as long as my fingernail. And then we're gonna nestle an orb inside there, but what I am hoping for, see if I can get a piece of scrap paper here, is that we have this little orb and this U-shaped line is going to wrap around it, kind of making this little rope type area. So we don't want our U way up here, I mean our orb. We really want it to nestle right around it. That makes sense? Okay, so I'm gonna put my orb right there and add a little reflection. And then this next part, I'm going to come to the side of the circle, touching that circle, and I'm gonna come up, and then I'm going to curl around and over this part. And then I like to just come in nice and tight and make a little spiral. So I go on this side over here. Now I'm going to go the opposite way, but I go on this side and I come up following this little line and then I curve around. Isn't that cute? So see how it looks like that orb is nestled in this cute little U-shaped curly thing. Okay, and then towards the top, I'm gonna do 3 bumps, and I'm gonna make the middle one a little bit taller than the other one. And if you would like to, you can aura that, but you don't need to. And now we're gonna put these petals up here, and I'm gonna make my petal go pretty close to the center since I've got room for four more around here. So I'm gonna go up like that and come down. So it's a little bit wider at the top than at the bottom. I really need to keep scrap paper around here. Okay, and then for your petals, oh, here was some other ways that you can do it. You can come up and do more of a curly Q like that if you want. Okay, and then for your petals, I'm going to build off of them like this. But you also could just put in a whole petal if you want to. So I'm going to go down a little bit and I'm going to curve and come down and down and down until I get to the end or where I think the end should be. And then I do the same thing on this side, and I'm just always going down a little bit on each side. And then in here I put a long line and then two short lines. Isn't that pretty? Okay, let's do another one. So I like to start with my U shape and remember about the height of my nail and about the width of my pen. My little center line here is off a bit. Then I nestle in that orb. Put a little reflection. Then I go up the side of the circle and I come down and curve in. Up the side, down and curve in. And of course you can make these taller if you want, shorter if you want. Then I put in those three bumps with the one in the middle being a little bit taller. And I aura that. And then I put in the tall petal. And then these ones that get progressively shorter. And if this overlapped or had to go underneath it, that would be fine. I didn't even know how it was going to work out, and it worked out okay. Okay, add our three little lines here. And then we turn it. I'm not sure why my diagonal lines were so off, but okay, put in my U. And my orb. And if you make your U's a little bit taller, then you know you've got a little bit different shape. So I go up the side and I come down and curve in, up the side and curl around. One, two, three bumps. One, two, three. Add in the tallest petal first in the center. And come down both sides. Add those little lines off the orb. There we go. All right, one more. U. Orb, come up the sides, one, two, three. Aura it. Large petal and smaller petals. Add in those little lines. And there we go. So you can see where, let me see if I can find Kahlua. Okay, so Kahlua was the one where we did the orb, then we did those little shapes coming out. So you could do that same thing and have these four orbs be around the center. I just thought it'd be fun this way. And then the artist, Stephanie Jennifer, also does it as a border pattern. So she makes one this way and then puts a couple little orbs and then adds the next one and a couple of orbs, and it's beautiful. So lots of options. Okay, for this one, I've got a couple more minutes, so we're going to do a little bit more detail and then we will do some shading. So because I have it in this cute little frame, I thought it would be fun to add an interior line now to make a thicker frame. Let me show you. I'm going to come in down here and go like that, right along following that edge. And then over here, I can imagine the same thing coming this way. And this way. And this way. See how I made this little tiny area inside? I also thought it'd be fun to add a little bit of texture in this background. So I could just shade it, but just for fun today, because I like doing new things, I'm gonna put in some very light texture lines as a background. That's kind of cute. All right, I'm going to initial my work and do some shading. So not all of you are comfortable shading, but those of you that are know that it just takes this piece and turns it from kind of flat to having some dimension. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go on the top of each orb and add a little bit of graphite. So right where those three lines touch that orb, then I take my blending tool and I'm just going to push it up and away from the orb. That's so cute. And then where it nestles in down here, I'm going to give just the slightest graphite. So at the bottom of the orb where it's nestled in, and give a little bit of a shadow. And then I'm going to go right at the top of those three bumps where the petals come down. Put it in there kind of thick and dark. And I can even go over, see that petal touches or tucks behind that curve. I can even put a little bit of a shadow there. So basically just at the bottom of those petals, wherever they land. Then I can push these up into those petals. Look at how pretty that is. Just like that. So cute. Okay, now I'm going to put some on the inside of this frame But also I'm going to go around, just kind of one pencil line, around each of these Sendeo shapes. So pencil line on that frame and then around these shapes. I've already got that texture in the background, and now this will just make it a little bit darker back there. Just softly soften that away from the line. There we go. Just like that. Last thing I'm going to do, even though we're already over our time, is I'm going to put a tiny bit around this part that goes over the frame. So I'm just going on the outside of that U and the outside of those curves. And all that's going to do is kind of lift this shape off of that frame a little bit. See, a little bit of shadow just kind of lifts that up. There we go. Beautiful. All right, let's add it to our compilation piece. So mine is an 8x10 piece of watercolor or maybe a mixed media paper. And this has the first 21 days on it, so I still need to fit 10 tangles. And now's the tricky part. Do I make these tangles large or small? How are they gonna fit in? But we're just gonna go for it and hope that it all fits, okay? So this is day 22, Sendeo. I never have a plan. I just sort of figure out where I want to add this. So right now I'm trying to decide if I want to add it in four corners like that, or if I want to put them all around an orb, kind of like this one, or tuck them in individually, or maybe make a string of them. I think that's what I'm going to do. I think I'm going to make a little string of them somewhere, and then we'll put the rest of our tangles around it. Okay, that's the plan. So where to put it? Let's put it right here. Let's fill in this space a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna zoom in, set that aside, and I'm just gonna go for it with my pen and hope it works. You know what? I'm changing my mind because I don't really wanna draw this way. I wanna draw this way. So let's put a string of them from here to here. Okay, new plan. Of course, you can put yours anywhere you want if you're doing a compilation like this. So I want to try to get maybe three or four of them. I'm going to make a little bit of a trail that I can follow. Okay. And I'm going to begin with that U shape. And I'm just going to let that go right behind this one. I don't like things like sticking out from each other. I like them to kind of connect and intertwine and sit behind each other. So that's gonna tuck in behind. And I'm gonna add that orb in the center with my little reflection. Go up the side, come down and curve in. Up the side, come down and curve in. One, two, three. One, two, three. And I think I'm going to ink that in this time, just to give a little darkness, a little drama to that. And those three lines before I forget. And then I'm not gonna make my petals too tall because I wanna fit a couple of these in here. So I'm just gonna go a little bit like that. and down the sides. So, so pretty. Okay, now let's add, let's see, let's just do one. I'm just gonna do one because I wanna make sure I can fit some more in. So now I'm gonna do that U shape again. Orb. I tend to go a little faster in these compilation pieces just because I've already explained the tangle, so I want you to kind of be able to get through this one a little bit quicker. Okay, so I've got that. Put in the three bumps, or the three bumps. And darken them. Three little lines. Petals. Think I can squeeze one more in there? Let's try it. I'm gonna have to go off my path a little bit. I think I'm gonna have to kind of go more this way to fit it in. Always changing and adjusting. Okay, a little circle here. U shape. Orb. Touch the side of that circle. Up and around. Up and around. One, two, three. One, two, three. Darken it in if you want. Your compilation piece does not need to look like mine, so please feel free to put this wherever you want, in any direction you want. Okay, do my petals, and now I'm hoping they bump into this one, so I'm gonna make that go nice and tall. And come down the sides. And of course, yours will probably land differently. Even if you try to make it exactly like mine, it'll land different. So if you end a little bit short from where you want it to land, just do another one. Or just stop and put another tangle in there at some point. It's okay. Got my little lines in there. So cute. I'm going to add an additional little line and dot in these petals. Just for some texture. So very cute. And now I'm just trying to decide, should I aura around that whole thing? I'm worried it's gonna get like lost once I add more tangles. So I think I am gonna take the time right now to aura it. So auraing is just like walking beside it. This part is not necessary, but it does separate it from the other tangles. Ooh, I was gonna aura this next one. Let's just bring that right down there and we'll just let that line be. Okay. I have to concentrate so much when I aura. And then I've got room down here for a little aura. I've got this space that's finished off right here, so I can add an orb or some lines, or I can just darken it in. We'll do that. Okay, let's add some shading and see how this looks. I'm gonna add my shading on the top of my orbs. And at the bottom of my orb, the top of those three bumps, or the bottom of the petals, whichever way you want to look at it, is that it for now? Okay, let's take our pencil and push all of that up. Now, another thing you could do with shading, even on the individual tile, it just kind of gets a little bit tedious, but here's a petal, and there's a petal tucked in behind it, so you can always add the slightest little bit of a shadow. See how that kind of pops that out? So I'm not going to do it on here just because I don't think I have enough room, but I'll do one just so you can see it. See, it kind of just ends up getting covered in graphite, but it does give it some layering. Okay, and then I think while I'm here, I'm gonna double check. So this tangle goes over this one. So I wanna add a shadow everywhere that goes over it. So it looks like this one is tucking in behind. And then right here, it tucks in behind this one. So I want to add a shadow there and there. That makes sense. And okay, I'm going to do one more thing. See, this is never planned. I'm sorry. I'm going to add a shadow around the outside of this whole thing because the next 10 days of tangles are going to have to be going in and around this. And instead of shading each day, each spot it goes over, if I just add the shadow now, then it's in place. Just doing a quick little outline. And then I'll push it up and away. And I can soften this and blend it more later when the other tangles are in. But now that shadow is there, so the next tangles I draw around it will already look like they're tucking in behind. Okay, let's see how this looks. Wow, 22 tangles. This is so exciting. So 9 more to fit in. I'm so excited. Thank you so much for following along for this month of daily challenges. And hope you have a wonderful week, and we'll see you tomorrow. Thank you. Bye-bye.